This short video explains how to create a part number for a Celera encoder and how to use the encoder product configurator. An encoder part number is made up of 7 individual elements. Each element refers to a particular product characteristic, such as mounting format, outer diameter, and resolution. Simply select from the range of choices in each of the 7 elements and you'll end up with the right product for your project. Start with the element on the left and work towards the right. The first element refers to the mounting format. If you reference the relevant encoder product guide, either Mini, Midi, Midi Ultra, or Maxi size range, you'll see various mechanical formats described in drawings. Choose the format that best suits your project. You might also find the 3D CAD files on our website useful. You'll find these in the resources page of our website of the encoder products. You can mix and match different mechanical formats of stator and rotor, but not sizes, and this can be reflected in the part number. For example, you can have a screw mount stator with a set screw rotor, and this will be referred to as INC7. INC10 refers to a duplex arrangement or 2 encoders in a single housing. These are mostly used for safety-related applications where there's a need for electrical redundancy. In our example, we'll pick the most common selection, which is INC3, or screw mount stator and screw mount rotor. The next element is size, specifically outer diameter. Note that this is only a nominal size. Check the product guide or 3D CAD files for the actual dimensions that are going to be right for you. There's a couple details to note here. A duplex INC10 format only starts at 125mm, and not all communication options are available in the MIDI, MIDI Ultra, and the Maxi size ranges. In our example, we're going to pick 75mm. The next element is resolution. Resolution refers to the number of measurement steps over 1 revolution. 10 bits refers to 1024 steps. 11 bits refers to twice as many, 2048. 12 bits is twice as many again, 4096 steps, and so on. If you want the encoder to match an existing device with an A/B pulse output, you can also specify the number of pulses per revolution. In our example, we're simply going to use 10 bits of resolution, 1024 steps. The next element is communication interfaces, or comms. The encoder series offers SSI, ASI, SPI, BIS-C, analog voltage, and AB pulses. It also offers single turn or multi-turn. Synchronous serial interface, or SSI, is the most common choice for absolute encoders, and SSI1 is the most frequently chosen. Refer to the encoder product guide for additional detail. ASI is similar to SSI, but there's no synchronization clock signal. SPI is serial peripheral interface and is widely used between encoders and microcontrollers. BIS-C is very similar to SSI and is popular in the latest generation of motor controllers. AB pulses is mostly used for incremental encoders and motor drives. The analog voltage outputs of 0 to 5 or 0 to 10 volts are mainly used as replacements for potentiometers, usually in process control, test, and development applications. If you're looking to match an encoder with a controller, you can check compatibility with the tables shown on the Celera Motion website. You'll find these in the documents section on the website for inductive encoders. In this example, we'll use the most frequent choice, SSI1. The next element is the connector. There is a large range of options, including axial and radial connections, as well as integral cables. The product guide shows all of the various details. Integral cable options are useful if your project has harsh conditions, such as water, dirt, or aggressive vibration. If you need an extra long cable fitted, this is possible. Contact Celera Motion for more information. If the encoder is used in mineral oil, you don't necessarily need an integral cable. All the connection options will work fine in mineral oil. In this example, we'll choose the most common choice, axial connector, AC1. The next element is supply voltage. For operating environments with temperatures up to 105 Celsius, select the 5HT option. For low temperature applications, down to minus 60, choose the 12 CT or 24 CT options. For analog voltage output, you'll need a 12 or 24 volt supply. In this example, we'll choose the most common supply, 12 volts, which covers a range of 4.5 to 32 volt DC supply. In the final element, the default selection is AN for standard anodized surface finish. However, you can also add some extended range options. Some applications that might need this would include aerospace, security, and special industrial applications. Options include ultra high shock and vibration, thermal stress screen and bake out, Certec rather than anodized surface finish. This is for when a conductive surface finish is required. High operating pressures, leaded rather than unleaded solder, grade, serial and part numbers, and conformally coated sensor surfaces. In this example, we won't choose any extended range options, we'll just select the default anodized surface finish. So now we have built a part number and we have a list price. You may order online or generate a quote. If ordering online, you can pay by credit card or send us an order number using the pay offline function. Don't forget cables. These can be found on the accessories part of the website. Prices on the website are list prices. Discounts apply for quantities of more than 9 units. Contact us for more information by visiting celeramotion.com/contact.